open your eyes slowly and start to move your head from side to side very gently without forcing. Just bring one ear closer to the shoulder and then bring the chin down and rotate to bring the other ear to the other shoulder. Now keep doing that, but turn your eyes first in the direction where you want your head to go, and then go all the way. Follow your eyes. Open your eyes. Look out to the side and then up and then down and forward. Now, if you sit on the block, you can remove the block and sit down here. Extend one leg forward, spread the toes and fold the other leg in. Press one hand flat here. So if the left leg is straight, press the left hand flat and turn the torso. So the shoulders are in line with this left leg. Take the right arm up and press the left hand down. Breathe in. Breathe out softly. Lower both shoulders down and squeeze your left rib cage. Bring the chin down and open the right shoulder more towards the back. Straighten your right arm. Take it above your head towards the ceiling. Then drive the shoulder down. Bring the chin down. Inhale, send the heart forward a little. And breathe out, open more. Press the left hand down. Then you send your arm away from your head or your hand away from the shoulder. Lower the palm down to feel the stretch in the neck. Breathe in softly through the nose. Breathe out softly. Lower your right hand down, the palm stretching, fingers spreading wide. Reach out, keep reaching, keep feeling the neck. Breathe through the right side of the neck. Relax the face. Then drive the right arm across the back. Open from the shoulder. Maybe you grab the opposite thigh here. Keep pressing your left hand. Breathe in, lift your heart, send the right shoulder back. Exhale to squeeze the left rib cage. And come out slowly. Keep looking down. Send both hands forward in front of your chest. So you're looking to a 45-degree angle. Press both hands down and feel your shoulders. Make sure one shoulder is not higher than the other, or one hand is not pressing harder, more firmly than the other. Feel the lower back. Spread the toes in the front foot and keep the toes spreading. Lengthen the rib cage forward, inhale. Exhale softly through the nose. Do not make attempts to go down, or at least not quickly. Just focus on how it feels to breathe here in the lower back, between the ribs. What can soften? Spread the toes. Relax the face. Stay here for a moment. Keep the chin up, lengthen, send the chest bone forward just a little. Breathe out to soften shoulders. Maybe the elbows come down. Do not send the hands too far forward. Make sure you can feel the ribs moving forward on the inhalation. At some point, maybe the elbows come down. Look down if you want. Keep the spine long and the left foot active. Slowly bring the chest up and come out to switch side. Now, if for some reasons you feel very uncomfortable in around the knee joints, the meniscus, grab one of your blocks or a cushion and support the back of the thigh. And if both knees feel this way, support both knees. One here, one here. Right hand flat, shoulders in line with the right leg, open the left arm up, breathe in. So the hand moves up towards the ceiling and you spread all fingers. Bring the chin down, relax the right shoulder down and start to squeeze the right rib cage, lower the chin, relax the neck. Press the right hand down and spread the right toes. Take a few breaths here, nothing forceful. Stretch the left rib cage a bit more. Lift the armpits high above the hips. And then extend the left arm towards the back. The palm coming 20 or 30 centimeters off the ground. Breathe from the belly. Then send the arm across the back. Rotate the shoulder out. Exhale to bring the belly in. Keep toes active, keep pressing the right hand down. And keep neck relaxed as much as you can. And then slowly release. Face forward. Not forward towards the foot, to a 45 degree angle between the two legs. And move the lower ribs forward, inhale. Soften the belly down, exhale. You can close your eyes and tune into how you feel in the lower back. Make sure the right sit bone is connected to the floor. Level your shoulders. Bring a bit more space between the ribs as you move forward, just a little inhale. Exhale. Now, if you haven't activated your Ujjayi breath, do it now. If you're not familiar with Ujjayi breath, it's a breath that you can feel in the throat. You can feel a whispering sound in the throat if you don't feel it, create this whispering sensation. Why Ujjayi breath? For many reasons, but right now you might notice that it will allow you to make the breath longer, gives you control on the intensity of your breath. And by observing and feeling that, you stay focused. You don't think too much. which is very counterproductive in yoga. Send the lower ribs forward, inhale. Lower forearms down, exhale. Right sit bone down. And slowly come up. It's not always that we start with yin postures, but yes, the lower back can always benefit from opening at any point in the practice. Really, bring the knees up. And then lower knees out to the side, connect your feet. And bring the fingertips just behind the butt. Push your groin towards the feet, towards the heels. Curl the toes out and lift your heart high. Breathe in, shoulders move back, open your mouth wide, breathe out fully. Now we're going to do some Kapalabhati breathing to ignite the inner fire, abdominal fire. Now, if you've got asthma or high blood pressure, do only 20 rounds. And if you don't have those conditions, you do 80 in your own time. You can breathe out through the mouth or the nose, but I would suggest do it through the nose if you can. So how do we do that? If you're not familiar, breathe in softly to let the belly come out. Breathe out sharply to pull the belly in. Keep the heart high. Breath in, sharp breath out. Lift your heart more. 20 more. Pull the belly all the way, sharply. And keep your eyes closed and feel the effects on your face, in your neck and chest, in your back. And send your hands forward. Take a deep breath in. Empty out. Then pull the belly in and up. Suck it in. Lock the throat down and squeeze the pelvic floor. Fall forward. No breathing for a few moments. Then unlock the throat, come up, breathe. Take a deep breath in again. And again, belly comes in, behind the ribs, all the way in. Lock the throat down and fall forward, squeeze the anus. And come up slowly. Come on your back. Bring the knees towards the shoulders. Hands on the knees, take the knees wide and rotate on the lower back with the head on the floor, the back of the head connected to the floor. Open the knees wide and rotate in both directions. And bring the feet flat and come into a bridge. So if you have a block and you want to start with a supported bridge, let's do this version first, supported bridge. Feet flat, the lower legs are vertical. Stack the joints vertically, it brings stability and it's safer for the joints. Have the tailbone to point up towards the ceiling and slowly lift the lower back, lift the spine up, lift the heart and bring the block to support the sacrum. Feet flat and thighs parallel to each other. Rest your shoulder blades down, the palms face forward. Let the weight of the pelvis, of the lower back, press it onto the block. But do not let the thighs fall out from the center. Keep the knees hip distance apart. Stay here for a moment. Notice how you feel around your face. Relax the face. Notice how you feel around the diaphragm area. Let the diaphragm orchestrate the breathing softly. Feel your ribs moving away from each other gently. The shoulders relaxing against the floor. Now take your right leg up towards the ceiling. Press the left foot down and take the right leg high. The right foot higher. Leg straight, spread the toes and rotate the leg a few times. Not the foot and the ankle, the whole leg from the hip. And make the circles wider. Press the left foot down. And circle in the other direction. 3 or 4 or 5 times. Keeping the leg as straight as you can. And bring the foot down. And switch. Switch side. Elongate the leg first. Gentle rotations to feel the connection, thigh, hips. And go wider. Bring the foot down. Turn the tailbone up. Lift the hips a bit higher. Remove the block. Come on your back. Bring the feet together and lower knees on one side. Keep shoulder blades down. Now, when you lower the knees on the side, you don't want to have the legs starting to unfold. Keep the legs bent together and take the knees higher towards the chest. Rotate your head out to the opposite side. Relax neck and face. Maybe your hand comes on the knee here, because you will notice that the top knee moves back. Yes, because the body wants to roll back, create more balance. So bring the knees maybe more aligned together if you can. And send the shoulder blades down. Soften the belly. And the hip joints. And the thighs. Slowly come out, knees up, feet flat. Take one breath in. Breathe out to lower both knees to the other side and keep them close to the chest and align together if you can, vertically. So let me turn around so you can see what my knees are doing. If you can bring the knees on the same vertical line, not like this, like this. And let the shoulder blades go down. Roll your head out, your head out. Now the knees might not stay on the vertically aligned. It's okay. I'm just trying to bring your attention to what the body is doing. Let's bring awareness in the way the body moves and feels. Let's not fight to create any particular situation or to avoid any particular situation. Slowly come out, start to roll on your back, back to front. And we're going to move through some sun salutations now. So when I stand up, you might not see my head, but you can hear my voice. So I'll just keep moving. I'm going to face the lights. Yeah, it's always a good choice, right? So roll on your back a few times. Let your back press down, then come forward, cross the legs, and come into a plank. Now make your plank active. We're not here by accident. We're here willing, taking ownership of this moment and this configuration the body's in. Spread your fingers, push the chest away from the mat, curl the tailbone down until you feel your butt squeezing towards the back of the thighs. Push the heels back. Kneecaps away from the mat. Or maybe down. Just notice how you feel. Stay in the plank for a moment. Hold it. Now, if you feel like your hips want to collapse down, then you need to bring your knees down. If you have the knees down or not, take one more breath in. And as you breathe out, move your chest forward slightly and lower the chest between your hands. Squeeze armpits towards each other. Then come down, lengthen your legs, your toes, bring the hands forward. Cut the tailbone down towards the earth. Lift your heart gently, start to spread the ribs up. Breathe in, send shoulders away from your ears. And come down, exhale, move to downward facing dog. Curl the toes, send the hips back before sending them up. Take a breath in through the nose, spread all 10 fingers and toes. Breathe out to bring the belly in and lift the tailbone. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the nose. Take a breath in, bend the legs slightly if you want. Rotate shoulders out, press the hands down, extend the spine and the sides of the torso, push the heels down, belly comes in, breathe out. Stay here for 3 breaths. Rotate the upper arm out, feel the space between the shoulder blades expanding. Push the hips back, soften the face. One more breath. Now soften into the knees, look forward and step forward. Bend the legs slightly and lengthen torso forward, inhale. Fold, exhale. Come up all the way. Sweep both arms up, inhale. Bring hands to your heart, exhale, close your eyes for a moment. Bring the feet together, parallel to each other. Inhale, lift your heart, curl the tailbone down, Exhale, soften neck and collarbone area, collarbones. Now look up and send your hands above your head as high as you can. Press the feet down, breathe in. Exhale to fold forward. Then elongate to a long flat back. Exhale to fold. Press the hands down. Set the left foot as far back as you can. And make sure your right foot is between your hands. Left foot back, flat this time. We can do it flat, we can take the heel up, but this time let's do it flat. Fingertips down, lower the hips. Bring them down and forward and elongate the torso forward, lower the hips, breathe in. Breathe out to come back to plank. High plank, lower the plank, exhale. Cobra, inhale. Tailbone down, lift your heart, shoulders down. Downward facing dog, exhale. Take a breath in through the nose. Open your mouth, sigh out. Bend the legs, step the left foot between your two hands and do the same thing. Okay, I'll switch sides from side to side from time to time. It's just so you can see each side of the body, but obviously you stay facing forward. One breath here. On the exhale, you step the front of the mat to fall forward. Inhale to unfold. As tall as you can. Exhale to bring your hands to your heart. Rise up, inhale, look up. Exhale to bring the hands to the floor. Flat back, breathe in, elongate spine. Exhale, press the hands down, spread the 10 fingers, take the right foot back. Let's do the same thing here. Fingertips down, lengthen your spine, inhale. Plank, exhale, high to low plank. Inhaling into cobra. Exhaling into down dog. One breath in through the nose. Breathing out through the nose. Spread your fingers, press the thumb and the index knuckles down. Straighten arms, rotate the upper arms out, shoulders away from the ears, away from the wrist. The lower back, the hips move back, the heels move down. Take a breath in. Breathe out, then soften into the knees and take your right foot between your hands. Left knee down, left leg long, hips down, spine long, inhale. And step up the front, two fold. Come into a long flat back, breathe in. And exhale to fold again. Look back, catch the elbows, take the feet wide, wider than the hips. Send the hips forward so they come vertically aligned with the ankles. Catch the elbows and gently swing from side to side with a very gentle rotation of the spine. So you bring your ribs to touch your thighs maybe, or you let them touch. There's no real muscular activation here. It's just the weight creating this pendulum effect. Let it be. Let the breath move you, move through you. And then bring the feet together. Take both arms up towards the ceiling. Sit low and curl the toes off the floor. Chair pose. Curl the tailbone under, bring the belly slightly in and sit lower. Bring your hands to your heart. Inhale to lengthen up. Exhale to twist slowly. Move slowly. Maybe the elbow comes outside of the the opposite thigh, maybe not. Twist from the core, from the mid back. Try not to twist your neck. So look down at your toes, let the neck relax, the head heavy. Awareness in the back, in the spine. Breathe in to expand around your heart. Breathe out to roll the right shoulder back more. Press the feet down. One more breath. Breathe in. Let the lower ribs move up. Breathe out. Bring the belly in and twist more. Then relax. Come back to a fold, forward, catch the elbows, bend the legs, relax the jaw. Bring the feet together, chair pose. Sitting low, expanding upward, hands to the heart, shoulders down, inhale, lengthen spine up, exhale to twist. Keep the elbows out. Knees maybe on the same line. Lift your heart, inhale, and twist, exhale. Toes off the floor maybe, sitting low. And relax. Ragdoll again, feet wide, pulling forward. Catch the big toes and bend the legs a lot. Lower the butts at the back. Lengthen chest forward, inhale. As you exhale, pull on the toes, lift the sit bones and lower shoulders and head. Look back. Take your elbows and shoulders wide. Open the space between the shoulder blades. Keep pulling on the toes and lift the sit bones up. Take a deep breath in and sigh out loud. And come out, cross the legs and sit down. Bring the left leg forward. The left shin parallel to the front edge of your mat. So the left leg is forward, but not straight. You bend the front leg and you bring the right foot around. Now make sure that both feet point forward and you're going to lower the right sit bone by rolling the right thigh out, coming into double pigeon. Fingertips at the back. Lift the heart, inhale. Relax the jaw. Exhale. Can bring your hands to the side if you prefer, but maintain space between the ribs. Allow the intercostal muscles to receive plenty of breath. Breathe deep towards the hip joints so they can soften. Relax your hands and shoulders if you want. Keep the feet active and just notice, let your awareness move around the body. Feel the contact with the ground, like a rock at the bottom of the ocean. Sit heavy, unmovable. If you can make the breath a bit slower. Flex your feet. Now slowly push with the fingertips to move your heart forward. Send the shoulders back, chest bone forward, inhale. Send your hands forward, fingertips. Elongate your lumbar spine. Keep the sit bones down and traction the ribcage forward, inhale. Keep the chin up, soften belly down, exhale. Stay in the pose. If you have a block, grab the block to come forward. Maybe two blocks or three. Relax shoulders and jaw. Then slowly come up. Lift the right knee up, bring the foot flat, and circle the leg out. Then switch side. Right leg down, left foot comes around. Rotate the thigh out. Prepare your blocks, your cushions maybe. Breathe. Expand upwards, inhale. Relax face and neck. Activate the feet. Take your time. Doesn't matter how low we go. We just want to feel. Slowly start to lengthen yourself forward. Chest bone moving forward, the lower ribs moving forward away from the hips. And we exhale to soften into the hip joints. Feeling the stretch in the glutes as well. This is where the Ujjayi breath is really key to melt the tension, the stiffness, the tightness away. So use the Ujjayi breath to lengthen the breath, also to stay focused, to keep your attention moving inside of the body. Notice where are the areas of tension that needs your attention. Ujjayi breath helps to do that. You can breathe out loud with voice, with sounds, for releasing tension or fear. Slow breath in, soft and slow breath out. Slowly come up. Use the same path you used to come in the pose to come out of the pose. Now lengthen both legs forward. Lengthen up and shake the legs. Roll them in and out. And come on your back. Mini Shavasana. Now bring the right knee towards your chest. Lengthen the left leg or keep it long against the floor and drive the knee towards your chest, pulling, lengthening the hamstring with both hands here. Then gently press it down and bring the lower leg vertical. Drive your right arm inside of the right thigh, catch the outside of the foot, and slowly bring it down. Bring the knee down. Do not bring the foot towards the groin, keep the lower leg vertical. Just notice what can open, what can soften. Do not try too hard, just allow time and breath and gravity to do the work. Usually does. And grab the big toe, take a breath in. As you breathe out, lengthen the leg up. Pull on the toe. Maybe you drive the hamstring up. You lengthen, you help it to lengthen up. Pull on the big toe at the same time. Squeeze the big toe and open the leg out to the right. With the hand maybe on the left hip. Lengthen the left leg. Shoulder blades down, face relaxed. And come out. Switch side. So I haven't checked the time. I think we're probably in the hour now. So let's do this and then we come to Shavasana. Just follow your breath for the timing. I might not call the next movement. You just decide when the time is right. Let your breath tell you and your body. Stay in your Ujjayi breath. Use the exhalation to soften, to bring the knee down. Big toe grab. The sacrum is flat on the floor. You lengthen the left leg up, curl, pull on the toe. Maybe you move the leg in and out a few times. With the rotations. And then you take the left leg all the way out to the left. With the hand on the right hip. Right shoulder blades down. Spread the right toes. Activate the right leg. Soften into your breath. And come out. Now, choose any final pose before lengthening yourself long and flat into Shavasana. Maybe a happy baby pose, maybe a supine twist. Once you get into Shavasana, send the heels as far away from the hips as you can, away from the butt, and relax the back of the knees. Relax the hip joints. And if you have your blocks or some cushions that you can bring to support the back of your thighs, your lower back will feel even more relaxed. Just under the close to the attachment with the seat bones. Then let the legs roll out. Let the torso and the whole body slowly soften down. Maybe spread like bread dough or clay. Softening, expanding. Let go of the Ujjayi breath. Maybe you want to take one or two deep breaths in and out to release any remaining tension. And let your face soften, your neck, shoulders. Let your spine press a bit more firmly into the mat. And notice the movement of your abdomen and chest as the soft diaphragm is regulating the breath to come to a very natural rhythm, soft sensation around the face. Let your arms and legs be heavy. Let all your bones be heavy. And simultaneously with feeling this heaviness, groundedness that exists in the body, feel the lightness and spaciousness. Let all the space around your heart, the back of the lungs, really feel the breath moving all around it. Feel the space that exists between both armpits, between the spine and the chest bone, between the neck and the lower back. In the hip joints and the groin. In the belly. And even in the muscles of your thighs and arms and neck. Just stay there in stillness for a few minutes, a few more minutes if you want. You can stay here for as long as you want. If you want to come out of Shavasana, start by deepening your breath very gently. And start to bring movements along the spine, top of the spine, the neck, head moving, rolling around. Move fingers and toes, wrists and ankles, arms and legs. Then squeeze the knees in towards the chest, tuck the knees in. And roll towards the right hand side. Don't be in any rush to come up. Take your time. Come up slowly, keep looking down, keep your neck relaxed. Push against the floor, come up. So sit up straight, tall and spacious. Connect your hands. Take a deep breath in and empty out. Bring the thumb knuckles on the third eye. Let's bow forward to acknowledge ourselves and each and every one of us present here.